Introduction. The white blood cell or leukocyte count allows to determine if the concentration in blood of these cells is normal or not. However, it does not provide information about the composition of the different leukocyte types in the sample. For this reason, the leukocyte formula is routinely conducted when performing a hemogram and provides further information. Methodology. The methodology consists in performing a blood smear into a thin layer or frottis. Normally, peripheral venous blood is used. After extension, the sample is dried and then stained. Required material. To conduct the frottis, the following material is needed: blood sample, Pasteur pipette, microscope slides, dyes to conduct a differential staining of the blood samples, washing solution, and tweezers. Frottis preparation. The blood sample can be either obtained directly from a puncture in the finger with a lancet or by a blood extraction collected in a tube with due anticoagulant. Using a Pasteur pipette, a drop of blood is placed close to the edge of the glass slide. With the use of another glass slide, which is polished along its edge, it is placed more towards the center of the slide while forming a 30 degree angle regarding the first slide with the drop of blood. By capillarity, the blood drop will extend along the surface of contact between the slides, and next the upper slide will be displaced in the opposite direction at due speed to form a smear, which is sufficiently thin and continuous. The blood layer thickness is proportional to the degree formed between the two slides. It is recommended that the slide employed for the extension has thinner or polished edge, enabling for a definite smear where the monocytes and polymorphonuclear leukocytes tend to be found. If this is not possible, we just displace the slide as to avoid coinciding with the other. After extending the blood sample, the blood frottis is set to dry. Then, three zones can be appreciated: a proximal zone towards where the drop was placed, a distal zone at the end of the frottis, and an intermediate zone, which is the optimal region to conduct the leukocyte count. Staining. The air-dried smear is then stained. The reagents are commercially available. We use the rapid panoptic method. Basically, it consists of fixing the sample and subjecting it to a mixture of acid and basic dyes that stain the cell structures differentially. The staining pattern is as follows. First, immerse the slide for 5 seconds, 5 immersions of 1 second, in fixation solution number 1. Second, repeat the same operation with reagent number 2, which is an acid dye such as eosine. Third, repeat the same operation on reagent 3, which is a basic type of dye such as methylene blue. Fourth, wash with distilled water and leave to dry. Then, the intensity of the staining can be varied by modifying the number of immersions in dyes 2 and 3. Depending on whether pink or blue tones are desired. In a good staining, the blood smear appears pink to the naked eye. Microscopic observation. After staining and eye drying the sample, it is examined under the microscope with 4x magnification, 10x magnification, 20x magnification, and 40x magnification objectives to see the distribution of the leukocytes. Since the distribution is often very uneven, as many leukocytes are mainly found at the edges of the smear. The study should be carried out over the entire width of the slide. Under the microscope, erythrocytes are pink, while leukocytes show much more intense purple or lila staining. The regions between the cells are clear, with no visible film or dye. After observing the distribution of cells, it is necessary to switch to the all immersion objectives to identify the leukocyte varieties. As each white blood cell is identified, a small outline of the characteristics of that type of leukocyte is made. Characteristics of leukocytes and their classification. Leukocytes have the characteristic of possessing a nucleus and cytoplasmic organelles, which allows for easy morphological differentiation. From the morphological point of view of the nucleus, leukocytes have been classified into two main groups: mononuclear, with a single large, rounded nucleus, which occupies practically the entire cytoplasmic volume, and polymorphonuclear, whose nucleus is lobulated and has multiple appearance. Depending on whether or not leukocytes have granules in their cytoplasm, they are classified as agranulocytes without granules in their cytoplasm and granulocytes with granules in their cytoplasm. Taking these characteristics into account, within the leukocytes classified as mononuclear and agranulocytes, we would find two types: lymphocytes and monocytes. While within leukocytes classified as polymorphonuclear and granulocytes, we would find three types: neutrophils, eosinophils, and basophils, depending on the affinity of the cytoplasmic granulation for the dyes used. Agranulocytes. Lymphocytes. These are the smallest of all leukocytes. They range in size from 6 to 10 micrometers. Lymphocytes are characterized by a large spherical nucleus with a deep blue staining. This nucleus is surrounded by a scanty cytoplasm that is free of granules and stains lighter blue than the nucleus. Lymphocytes represent about 20 to 40% of the total number of leukocytes. Monocytes. Monocytes are the largest leukocytes. They have a diameter ranging from 12 to 17 micrometers. Monocytes have a large, kidney-shaped nucleus that is stained more or less purple. In this case, the nucleus is surrounded by large amounts of cytoplasm, which is also free of granules and has a bluish staining. In the normal leukocyte formula, the proportion ranges between 2 and 8%. Granulocytes. Neutrophils. They range in size from 12 to 15 micrometers in diameter. The granulation of neutrophils stain is less intense, giving a more or less purple bluish color to the cytoplasm. They have a fine and very abundant granulation. Two types of neutrophils can be distinguished, the most abundant being segmented neutrophils, which, as their name suggests, have a nucleus with several lobes linked by chromatin and can therefore also be called polymorphonuclear and correspond to mature neutrophils. Banded neutrophils are less abundant and correspond to juvenile forms whose nuclei are not yet segmented and therefore appear as a band, hence their name. The total number of neutrophils in a normal blood sample is usually between 50 to 70% of the leukocyte formula. Eosinophils. Eosinophils are similar in size to neutrophils, between 10 and 12 micrometers. They contain abundant cytoplasmic granules larger than those of neutrophils. They stain with acid dyes, such as eosin, and are therefore red in color. Normally, their nucleus is bilobed, typical sunglasses nucleus appearance, and under conditions, this cell type represents between 1 to 4% of the leukocyte formula. Basophils. Basophils are also similar in size to the other granules. Their diameter ranges between 11 and 14 micrometers. In this case, the cytoplasmic granulation are sparser but coarser, as the name suggests. They are stained with basic dyes and have a dark blue or black coloration. Their nucleus is usually S-shaped, and they are the least abundant of all leukocytes, accounting for between 0 and 1% of the leukocyte formula. To obtain the leukocyte formula, 100 leukocytes are counted under the microscope, specifying number of each type of leukocyte found and expressing this value as a percentage of 100. This gives the percentage of each type of leukocyte in the sample analyzed.